Hey guys, Nina here, and welcome to the build site. For those of you who don't know, we are building a house by hand, which means gathering a lot of recycled materials and then putting it all together. In that vein, we're making our walls out of mud, as in we're making mud bricks from the mud on the farm we are living on. So I'm sure a lot of you have questions, why mud walls? Aren't they going to melt in the rain? And I'm basically going to be walking you through that. We've got a lot of time-lapse footage of us making them, gathering the whole process, so I'll explain it all as we go. And at the end, explain the next steps, and hopefully you guys will come along for that too. Thank you so much for joining us, and let's get into it. So the first important step of any process, as my dear nursing colleagues would know, is to gather your materials. One of those materials is hay. So we went on a gorgeous drive across the farm multiple times a week to fill the ute with hay. We probably would have had to do it less times, but the sheep in the paddock were very insistent on breaking into any container to eat it. From there, it was a matter of setting up our space. We placed various types of boards on the ground, MDF, chipboard, whatever would give us a nice flat surface. From there, we'd cover it in plastic so that when we put mud down, it wouldn't try and vacuum adhere to the board, which would have been unfortunate when we later tried to lift the bricks. We would wet the molds so that the mud didn't stick to those as well, and they were easier to lift off after we threw the mud into them. And then we kind of got to the making. The key ingredient to mud bricks is, of course, the mud, so we would remix the pit multiple times a day, throwing in various ratios of clay dust, water, and hay. It wasn't like we'd had measured it, we would mix it until it was good consistency. Obviously, that's pretty variable because they are organic materials, but we tried to get it as consistent as we could. So this is actually footage of our first day making the mud bricks. It's mostly at double speed because this video goes on for forever. I forgot how slow we were when we first started, and it makes sense. It's our first time doing anything like this. You can see Andrew and Gina shoveling the mud into the molds where we're compressing it, and then we flatten it out, take the molds off. We'll eventually get there at some point in the video, but it takes us a while. We took a long time to get into the swing of it, understand what we were doing, why we were doing. There's a lot of standing around, talking, figuring out the where's, the why's, the how's. I did a lot of bending over that day. I was compressing the mud with my knuckles, and there's lots of stones in there, so I ended that day with so many scratches on my knuckles I couldn't close my fists for days. Which is, you know, fine, except we went back to make more mud bricks the next day, and the day after. You know, that's just how it goes. You can kind of see the process of the brick making here. We'll get into it a little bit more. I've got a close-up footage of it. But it's basically throw the mud in, compress it down, flatten out the top, take the mold off. The little stick we use, we call a modulator, so if you hear me refer to it as that as we go, please don't feel too confused or lost. I'm still making this brick. I have been talking for so long, and I am still standing there making this brick as we talk at double speed. Oh, I was such a baby. But hey, there we go, we got there in the end. By week 3, we had a much better sense of what we were doing. We were faster and we were more confident, which makes sense because we'd been learning and growing the whole time. It was really cool and it felt empowering. We could feel the difference as we went. I don't know if you can easily tell because it is a time lapse, so it is naturally moving faster. I also realized time lapses are a much nicer way to film this because I hadn't done any video editing since grade 10 high school iMovie projects, so this is a whole new experience for me. Don't at me, I know. As a quick side note, yes, those are emus in the background. It's a wildlife conservation thing. The young one will be re-released into the wild at a later date. But yeah, with the wide angle viewing, I'm sure you can get a bit better sense of what I'm talking about when I try and describe the process. The whole throw the mud in, tamp it down, flatten out the top, take the mold off, and then go and rinse it so it's ready for the next one. So that close-up footage that I mentioned? Yeah, here it is. Nice mud in 2.7k at double speed. So as you can see, Cam throws the mud in, and we both kind of take turns tamping it down, because we want to make sure the mud gets into the corners so we don't have super wonky bricks. Also, on that note, we don't want to tamp it down too much, otherwise the mud leaks up out of the bottom, and the mold lifts, and it's just a nightmare because you get a lip, and then it's wonky, and it's all different shaped. Anyway, Then we try and level it out as much as possible and then flatten it using the modulator. Now that's to get a nice smooth top because those are the sides that are going to contact the others. And then we lift our mold up and we realize that, oh, there's some dry mixture in the corner and the corner is dry. But that's the perils of working with organics, I guess.
Seal spray foam is the ultimate solution for insulating and filling gaps in the home.
So depending on the weather and the mud mixture, anywhere between half a day to 2 days later, we'll go and turn the bricks onto their sides to make sure the side that was contacting the ground gets a chance in the sun to dry out a bit before we move them. So when we gauge the bricks are ready, or when we get round to it, we load them into the back of the ute, and sometimes the trailer as well, and drive them up to the shed we were keeping them in. Obviously, this is also pretty variable because again, it depended on the mud mixture or the weather. And you'll see as we load these bricks on, they're all so different. You don't know what mix you're gonna get that day, and you don't even know what shovelful of the mix you're gonna get. They're so strong, it's kind of ridiculous, and I'm not going to play this whole video, but there is going to be a jump towards when it gets dark. There is a full unedited version of the drive up the driveway, so if you want to see that, go have a look. We'll load the bricks onto pallets, and that's so that there's space between them, there's airflow, and they'll end up sitting out there for a month or two. They probably only need about 2 weeks before they're dry enough to place, but, you know, things take time. Between the pallets and the floor, we put a layer of metal sheeting, and that's so that the white ants, or the termites, don't eat their way through the bricks because they will eat anything. Now, by the end of this process, we ended up with 1,256 bricks. I haven't weighed these bricks, but I've been told they're about 20 kilos each, and I'm not going to do that calculation, but we had to move these bricks multiple times, and we will again when we actually use them at the build site. So, we got pretty strong through all of this. So, because I run out of footage in the order I'd want to talk about it, here is the tractor mixing the pit while we stand around with the dogs. So one of the questions that I rhetorically asked at the beginning of this video was, why are we making and using mud bricks? First of all, we can make them by hand from the materials on the farm, and we don't need to pay bricklayers to lay them because we're doing it ourselves, which really, really cuts down on the total cost of everything, and it's really nice to be able to use handmade and organic and recycled materials, basically. Secondly, the bricks, and therefore the wall itself, is a great thermal regulator. They're 250mm thick in the direction we're laying them, which is about the same thickness as a regular double brick wall with a gap in between, which is how most houses are built to provide insulation. So the house will stay cool when we want it to and warm when we want it to, and we don't need to worry about the temperature of the house fluctuating too much. Thirdly, the mud bricks are really strong. The thing is, they're not necessarily materials that are made or studied in a factory. They're all different, which is again the issue with using the organic materials and it being all handmade. But it also means we don't have things like a documented fire safety rating, and it meant the council really didn't want to let us use them. Some people have suggested that we give them to an honors student to study for their, you know, final project, but that's a bit behind us at this point. The biggest disaster we probably have to worry about in Western Australia is fire, and if it gets to the point of us worrying about that, I think we don't need to necessarily worry about the house. Considering it's a 700-acre farm, there's a few things we need to look for first. But if it does get to that, you know what happens to clay when it goes in a kiln? We don't really get huge floods or tornadoes or earthquakes here, so we don't really need to worry about that, but there is a high chance the house would still hold up if it did happen. The second question that I get asked the most is, isn't the mud going to melt or soften in the rain? And yeah, when you mix hard mud with water, it gets soft. But the way we counteract that is, first, we build the first layer of the wall with rock, so about 400mm from the pad is a rock wall before we start building the mud wall, so any water sitting on the ground isn't going to reach the mud at all. Secondly, we cover the outside of the bricks in a layer of oil, and everyone knows oil and water don't mix, it's going to repel the water, so that's another reason we don't need to worry about it. Lastly, mud stands the test of time. Andrew and Gina have already built a number of structures using these exact materials, and They haven't budged. Also, I was born in Zimbabwe and our first house was a mud hut. I moved there straight from the hospital, in fact. That stuff lasts. We really aren't going to need to worry about the structure and integrity of this build.
So thanks for joining us, guys.